So we talk a lot about the risk factors for repetitive strain injury here on this channel: speed, repetition, poor posture, awkward positioning, lack of pacing. But we don't very often talk about vibration. And I think it's important for people to know about this because that's an important risk factor for repetitive strain injury. And you probably won't get it from a computer, but you could if you're using a power sander to work on your home on the weekends. You could also get injured using a jackhammer or other heavy power tools that vibrate. So here to explain the role of vibration in repetitive strain injury is our chief medical expert, Dr. Robert Markison.
Click the subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you'll know when new videos are posted.
Really a combination of the vibrating tool and small amounts of trauma against the hand, the near side of the palm, and gripping to hold on to a vibrating object. Now, whether that's a motorcycle and you're shifting or braking and you're vibrating all the while without padded gloves, that's a risk factor. And so there have been reports of not only numbness and tingling, ulnar nerve territory, little finger, half of ring, carpal tunnel, thumb index, middle, and the other half of ring, but also vascular problems, vibration trauma in the water department, jackhammer operators, where they can ultimately even clot off the ulnar artery, which arches across the hand. 90%+ of the time, that's continuous with joining arches from the radial artery, so you're okay. But even so, there's risk of having vibration vascular related vascular problems. So vessels and nerves are vulnerable within vibrating tools of various kind of power and frequency.
When you say clot off, did I hear you clot off?
Yeah, clot off. I mean, actually close off a vessel. And if you have collateral flow from the other side, radial artery, as the ulnar artery is shut off, then you're okay, but not everybody does. So they can end up with ischemia, meaning pale fingers out here, and that's figured out by Doppler ultrasonography plus arteriogram imaging to look and see if you've clotted off a segment of a vessel.
If that happens to you, what is the treatment or what can you do to reverse or help the situation?
Well, besides backing off on the activity and so on and stopping smoking, because a single puff can shut down up to 60% of blood flow to the hand. That information came out in 1992. No smoking, stay well hydrated, keep the hands warm, use padded gloves. But if arteriography shows a little segmental cutoff with backfilling there, then you can just remove the segment and then vein graft and interposition graft to restore flow microsurgically. And so that can be very helpful, but you hope you don't get that far.
Yes, and one more question arises here. When you're talking about fingers going pale, is that related to Raynaud's?
It can be, but you see, a person with Raynaud's is at greater risk for vibration white finger syndrome, vibration trauma. And so Maurice Raynaud described peripheral vasospasm in 1903 among mostly French forestry workers, because he was working in France. And so there was a genetic tendency towards hands, fingers going whitish and purplish, which was eponymously named Raynaud's. And so they're at risk. And many of them at the time, at least, were smokers, compounding it by nicotine-related tight vessels, vasospasm. And so, yes, people with Raynaud's or cold hands in general are at greater risk for vibration trauma problems affecting both nerves and vessels.
So one more question. If you have this situation, you should probably lay off power tools such as sanders, jackhammers. That would be occupational, of course. Are there other sorts of things that you would want to avoid while you're trying to heal one of these injuries?
Again, it just if you're okay with padded gloves and so on, well hydrated, good microcirculation, oxygenation, nutrients, cell delivery, and wash out, the system is fresh and clean. But overgripping anything that's vibrating, motorcycles and so on, that's really something you want to back off on. An orbital sander is better than a hand sander. An orbital sander is, you just need a little guidance and they'll do their thing. And so again, we have a human tendency to overgrip everything and you don't need to.
Thank you, Dr. Markison. And I hope everybody will stay tuned because we are going to talk about motorcycles next.